Hey everyone, I am Shreya Jain and I am here again with a small game which we all love to play. The game is of jumbled words. Before starting, let me give you a summary of what we are going to do in this code. This is nothing, but there are two players in the game, player 1 and player 2. Basically, when we play this game, player 1 gives a word to second player by shuffling its letter, and then the second person has to guess its correct word by rearranging them, and so that the game goes on. By this strategy, we are going to code a game using Python. Let's start off by declaring a function named as play. And then we have to define it also. So let's define that function play followed by a semicolon. Here in the second line, you can see this indentation. This blank space is basically known as indentation, and it's much important in Python programming. Now we have to ask both the players to enter their name. So let's ask both the player to enter their name. Let's copy paste this text and ask second player to enter his name. So this is so. Now we have to store both the players' point. So let's declare two variables which will store both the player's point and initialize them to zero. Now each player will be given alternative turns, right? So here we are declaring another variable turn and initializing it with zero. We are initializing it with zero as it is generally a practice in computer science to initialize a variable with zero. Alright, also this game will go endlessly until one of the player wants to stop it. So to continue it indefinitely, that care has been taken by the while loop. So we are here using while loop, and condition we are giving here is 1, which means that it will always be true. We have to use a variable like a break, which will break this loop, and then the control will go out of it. Moving forward, now the next person has to get the question from the computer, right? So basically this is the computer's part. Here the computer will have a picked word, and we will provide it with one dictionary. Let's name that dictionary as choose. We will define this choose function later. And moving forward, then we have to create a question. Qn is the question. Question will do nothing, but it will jumble the word which has been picked. So it will jumble. Jumble is another function we will define later. And it will define the picked word. After the question is arranged, we will print that question. And here we have printed question. Yeah, so let's take a pause here. Stay tuned for upcoming part and do subscribe to our channel.